we see that three schools of thoughts, they are moving the finger in different ways. So al-Hanabila, when you mention Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, al-Shafi'iyya, when you say ashhadu, and al-Malikiyya, all the time, the only school of thought, they are only mentioned it once in the Salah, is al-Ahnaf. And when we are talking about this, only al-Ahnaf, we are talking about not the extreme people who considering moving invalid the Salah. Some of them consider it bid'ah, and they are saying a lot of things. So I read to you what some of the Hanafiya scholars are saying about moving, and what the Shaykh Rahmatullah Ali said to them and discussed this matter. So first of all, الأحناف, the original أحناف, الأئمة الثلاثة. In the Hanafi fiqh, when you say الأئمة الثلاثة, you're talking about Abu Hanifa, and Muhammad bin Hassan, and Abu Yusuf. These are the three Imams of the Ahnaf. We know Muhammad bin Hassan and Abu Yusuf are the students of Abu Hanifa. So, one of the scholars of the Ahnaf saying, الإشارة في التشهد هو قول أصحابها, يعني أهل الحديث, وهو قول أئمتنا الثلاثة. So pointing in the تشهد is what أهل الحديث saying. And he's saying, listen to this part. This is the saying of our three Imams. فقد قال الإمام محمد وبصنيع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم نأخذ, وهو قول أبي حنيفة. وقد ذكر أبو يوسف في الأمالي كما ذكر محمد على ما في فتح القدير وغيره. So here he mentioned that أبو حنيفة, محمد بن الحسن, أبو يوسف, the three Imams of الأحناف, the original أحناف, they are saying pointing in the تشهد is the sunnah, because they are following the hadith. This is why many brothers, many people who are following different schools of thoughts, they think we are following the Imam. The Imam, brothers, he is following the Prophet ﷺ. And no one of them, if he receives a hadith, if the hadith considered to be authentic for them, no doubt that they will say, oh no, I have my opinion about. They will follow the hadith. This is what they say in their books. This is what I'm saying to you in their books. They are saying, the three Imams of al-Ahnaf saying they are raising the finger in the tashahhud. And then he are saying, فالعجب كثير من علماء الحنفية كيف أنهم اختاروا ترك الإشارة في التشهد مع ثبوت ذلك عنه صلى الله عليه وسلم وعن أئمتهم أيضا. So, it is so strange from the scholars of the Hanafiya that they left raising the finger in the tashahud, while it is confirmed that the Nabi ﷺ used to do it, and also their Imams. And there is one of the great scholars called Malla Ali al-Qari, and he's Hanafi. He made a book about this matter and called it Tazyin al-Ibara li-Tahsin الإشارة. And he mentioned in that book many of them. He mentioned Hadith ibn Umar, Hadith Wa'il, Hadith ibn Zubayr, and there's other hadiths narrated. Then he mentioned some of them, and he mentioned an important thing. He said, كيف يجوز المؤمن بالله ورسوله أن يعدل على العمل بالحديث ويأتي بالتعليل في معرض النص الجليل معنى أن ذلك التعليل مدخول صدر من العليل وهو ما قيل بأن فيها زيادة رفع لا يحتاج إليها فيكون الترك أولى. He's saying, after mentioning the hadith, which is narrated and proved from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, how the people, the late Hanafi, they left the hadith of Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and they went to the opinions, saying, what's their opinion? Saying that salah needs khushu', khudu', all these things. So when you start moving the finger, this is against the khushu'. Doesn't work with the khushu'. And Sheikh Al-Albani, when he spoke to one of them, he said to him, okay, now I can understand the khushu' while you are reading like this. But the ruku' and sujood, also movements in the salah. So shall we leave also ruku' and sujood because this is doesn't go with the khushu'? If we go on this route, then we cancel many of the salah. And the salah is something, it is not happened to me or you or someone. It is according to the sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi. And he mentioned one of their opinion, one of their sheikhs, the Ahnaf. Just let me read to you what he said. He said, there is a scholar called Al-Kaidani. He mentioned there is many things which is muharram, haram in the salah. Listen to this. And he said, number 10, Al-Ishara bil-Subaba ka Ahl al-Hadith. He said, number 10 of the things which is haram in the salah is raising the finger as the Ahl al-Hadith doing. And he's saying, this is Mullah Al-Qari saying, and this is khata azim, this is a great mistake. And if I don't believe that this scholar or this sheikh who mentioned this, that he's good, he has good intention, I try to explain the things in a right manner, then I can say this is goes to the kufr. Why? Because he's denying an authentic sunnah which is narrated in the main books. So when you deny authentic sunnah, that this sunnah narrated from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he is saying this can reach that level. Then he is saying that when you know that this is what narrated from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then all the followers of Abu Hanifa must follow the hadith of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Then he said, وَكَذَا لَوْ صَحَّ عَنِ الْإِمَامِ فَرْضًا نَفْيُ الْإِشَارَةِ وَصَحَّ إِثْبَاتُهَا عَنْ صَاحِبِ الْبِشَارَةِ فَلَا شَكَّ فِي تَرْجِيحِ الْمُثْبَتِ الْمُسْنَدِ إِلَيْهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ كَيْفَ وَقَدْ طَابَقَ نَقْلُهُ الصَّرِيحُ مَا ثَبَتَ عَنْهُ عَلَيْهِ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ بِالْإِسْنَادِ الصَّحِيحِ. What he's saying, if it is narrated authentically from the Imam, Imam Abu Hanifa, that he's rejecting, or he's saying no pointing in the salah at all. And we have a confirmation, an authentic hadith, that the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam used to do it, then we should follow the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and leave what the Imam Abu Hanifa said. This is the right. Then he's saying, but it is narrated that Imam himself, Imam Abu Hanifa رضي الله عنه رحمه الله, he used to do this, and also his students. And then he's saying that some sheikhs, وغاية ما اعتذر به بعض المشايخ حيث منعوا الإشارة وذهبوا الكراهة عدم وصول الأحاديث إليهم. Some of the sheikhs, they said, oh, we don't know these hadiths. So we say, okay, if you don't know the hadith, then the hadith the hadith came to you and it's clear, what you'll do? You follow the imam or follow the prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? You follow the prophet sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam. So what I like to say, brothers, that this matter is clear, and the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to raise his finger in the salah, in the tashahud, and this is the sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So you move it up and down and you look at it during the salah, from you start until the taslim. Now we'll come to the next part, is sunnah or prayer sitting for the first and second tashahud. When Abu Humayd described the prayer of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said when he sat after two rak'ah, he would sit up on his left leg and keep his right foot upright. When he sat for the last rak'ah, he would pull over his left foot and put his right foot upright over the left foot and sit up on his entire posterior, related by Al-Bukhari. Now this, here there is a mention of two ways of sitting in tashahud. One of them we explained last week, which is we call it al-iftirash. And al-iftirash means that when you come from the sujood, you just bend your left foot, sit on it, and the right one will stay upright or straight. And this is called al-iftirash. Now, and this is for the first tashahud, the sunnah for the first tashahud. Now for the second tashahud, what you do? You put your foot under your leg and you sit on your butt. This is what we call it at-tawarruk. So this, and this is for the second tashahud. So the first tashahud, al-iftirash, you bend your left foot, sit on it, and the first one will stay upright. Now, in the second tashahud, the tawarruk, you'll put your left foot under your right leg and sit on your bottom. This is what we call it, at-tawarruk. And the hands will be, as we mentioned earlier. And this hadith related by Al-Bukhari, and the Sahabi who narrates this hadith is Abu Humayd, again, who described the salah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Is everyone clear about the two sittings? Okay, alhamdulillah.